was a strong start to all the indices this Monday morning, the 8th of April. We kick off with Goldstone Resources, with a signed farm-in deal with mining giant Randgold Resources. Exploration of the deposit will now proceed as a joint venture, with Randgold taking a 51% stake in return for funding to complete pre-feasibility study stages. Goldstone can then elect to contribute towards a feasibility study or dilute to 35%. Randgold has committed to at least 10,000 metres of reverse circulation drilling per annum up to the completion of the PFS, which must indicate that mining of at least 1 million ounces of gold is economically feasible. The JV will be terminated if that milestone is not reached. Meanwhile, a pre-feasibility study of Ortac Resources' Sturek gold and silver project in Slovakia has revealed it has good economic viability, with a projected mine life of 11 years and with an average annual gold production of 71,000 ounces of the metal. The report now recommends moving on to a bankable feasibility study as soon as possible. Hummingbird Resources has already started preparatory work on a definitive feasibility study for its Dugby gold project in Liberia, after what it says was a compelling scoping study result. The scoping study was based on average production of 125,000 ounces of gold annually from a 3.5 million tonne per annum tank leach operation. Landor Resources has revealed it intersected sulfide mineralisation at its Scorpion nickel copper cobalt project in Ontario, Canada. Pre-feasibility studies have begun on B47 as well as on the VW nickel deposit, while a drill program is being readied for preparation and will be carried out during the second or third quarter. High-flying mobile software specialist Globo is also in the news today, and it's on the way up after it said current trading is strong and 2013 should be a year of profitable growth. The update on current trading came as the group reported on a highly pleasing 2013 performance, which saw underlying earnings, EBITDA, from continuing operations surge 42% to 24 million euros from 16.9 million in 2011. Revenue there soaring 67% to 46 million euros. All this as junior oil firms also in the news. Kia Petroleum is one of them. Its second well on its Pukka field in New Zealand has produced strong flow results in its initial testing period, sparking a 4.5% rise in its share price. Meanwhile, Xcite Energy started the day nearly 8% higher after a significant increase in both reserves and value at the North Sea Bentley field. It's been over a year since the last reserves report from Xcite. And finally, Gemfields, the coloured gems producer, is down 10% on Friday. Zambia announced that all emeralds mined in the country should only be sold through auctions held in Zambia. Gemfields has a 75% stake in the KGEM emerald mine there. The government of the Republic of Zambia owns the remaining 25% stake. Gemfields also has a 50% stake in the Kariba amethyst mine, which will be similarly affected by the new pronouncement. KGEM is seeking clarification from the Minister of Mines, Energy and Water Development in Zambia regarding the terms, conditions and the basis of the measures which were introduced without consultation. That's a look at some of the stocks on the move on this Monday.